What's up with your squad? What's up with your nation? It's your boy Scoop, man. Back up on it. You know what I'm saying? I tapped in at the Hip Hop Lab, you know what I'm saying, with your boy Lando again. He out here doing his thug dizzle. Nah, I'm just fucking with y'all. But anyway, man, see your boy, TJ. You know what I'm saying? X6, boy. Mugshot. Released. You can't stop, man. Them stories, them methods, man. You gotta keep popping. You gotta keep going, man. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no stopping. The rap music money ain't enough, man. It's not enough right now, man. I'm just letting y'all know, man. And a lot of people think he faking. A lot of, like, you boy DJ Academics, you know what I'm saying? He talking about, is he signing no jumper? You know what I'm saying? Did he fake his, what you call, arrest? You know what I'm saying? At his show or whatever? That shit crazy, man. I really don't know. But, man, I know them boys be tapped in with that shit. You know what I'm saying? Buddy ass here riding that motherfucking scam wave so motherfucking hard, it don't make no sense. He ride that motherfucking scam wave so hard, he know if he go to the barbershop, a nigga gonna scam him on the haircut. Like, that's why he don't go to no barbershops, because he don't let nobody scamming that nigga. He ain't getting that close to nobody, let him touch, because that's how long he been scamming, bro. Anyway, man, shout out to this boy, man. Shout out to Lando, man. Make sure y'all go check out the Hip Hop Lab. Make sure y'all go subscribe. You know what I'm saying? TheHipHopLab.com. Go check out that too. You know what I'm saying? Go check out that website, man. Teejayx6 Mugshot Release. Let's see what they talking about.
Oh, it's Lando. It's the Hip Hop Lab, man. Nah, if you ain't hear the Teejayx6 by now, you're definitely tripping.
Right.
Recently, he's been going through a lot of stuff, a lot of different trouble. Detroit scam rapper was arrested in NYC at SOB's, and he had $50,000 on him and a good amount of fraudulent checks. Now, with that being said, fraudulent checks. What do you feel like TJ's outcome in this situation?
$50,000.
A lot of people thought it was
fraudulent checks.
But as I'm sure a lot of you have seen today, if you follow the Hip Hop Lab on Instagram, we posted TJ's mugshot. It is out there now. A lot of people went back and forth debating because they didn't think he was in jail. Now a lot of people think the mugshot is fake. So let me know what y'all think. Do you feel like TJ is scamming us all, or do you feel like he's really going through something right now? I feel like with him being at the height of his career, there's no reason for him to be acting like he in jail. It gotta be something going on.
It gotta be something going on. You know what I'm saying? You can only do that shit so many times to the point where a motherfucker's gonna catch on. You know what I mean? But FBI is always watching rappers, bro. Especially motherfuckers that catch a wave, especially on this type of wave, a scam wave, bro. They listening to everything. They writing down, they taking everywhere you be posted up at your shows, I guarantee you, it's a fed in the crowd taking pictures or something. He doing something. He there watching you, bro.
I think, man. Make sure you like, subscribe, and comment. And you already know, this is the Hip Hop Lab.
Man, shout out to the Hip Hop Lab, man. Real shit, man. Shout out to the Hip Hop Lab. They put niggas on what they need to hear, nigga. On my hood. So without further ado, you already know what we about to do. We about to tap in to your boy, TJ X6. You know I already been tapped in. What the fuck? I ain't trying to put free. See how they be trying to do me on here, y'all? There you go, right there. You know what I'm saying? He got his one album, The Swipe Lesson. You know what I'm saying? As a matter of fact, which one we going to? I got 1.5. I didn't tap into mostly all this shit, you see? I don't be faking, man. I ain't tapped into this one. So we're gonna do, is this a real? Yep, let's do it.
Suspect money back. But they secure so bad cause I still use the card. Use Verizon credit and a site let me clear my card. Some bank logins and I added it on Apple Pay. I got the fire being sent myself 2 bands per day. But sometimes I need to only hit for like me to go to Dollar General to grab a teddy bear and Giphy. Walk up to the counter like, can I load 5? Cause my sister graduated and I'm trying to buy her a few gifts. I used to have a petty ass being that only hit for lips. Now I got so many methods I can't even count them. Come back from the road to count the pros and the money count. Can't dress up as designer, gotta look like an out of towner. So just go to Foot Locker and buy a few fits. Gotta look like a rich black man about his business. I need some iPhones in my hands. Ask too many questions, man, stay out my business. You can get 3 iPhones off the business plan. And if you got a good pro, it's no down payment. If you start getting a few jacks, I advise you to save them. Cause you can sell them to the plug if it's ever a drought. Use a local Wi-Fi, don't do that shit at your house. Play some furniture from our van, my mama needed a couch.
I only been really doing the swiping shit for 3 years, but other than that, I've been straight scamming. Like, I've been straight scamming, Instagram scamming, Twitter.
Come on, man. You're gonna tell the whole world you've been swiping for 3 years, and after that, you just been straight scamming. Let me go back, man. Let's go back to this, man. Did you hear what this boy just said?
We've been really doing the swiping shit for 3 years, but other than that, I've been straight scamming. Like, I've been straight scamming, Instagram scamming, Twitter scamming, every kind of scam that you could think of. The Nigerian phone call. I used to do that, all that shit, bro. But now I just, like, the recent years, I've been fucking with the bank fraud and the credit card scams and shit. Even if some people say I'm stitching on myself, fuck y'all. Like, you know what I mean? Like, fuck y'all. Y'all's just mad because y'all can't even do the shit that I'm doing.
You heard what he said. You heard what he said. Even though he's snitching on himself, the people that saying he's snitching on himself, he said, fuck y'all. He don't care. He been scamming. Swiping cards for 3 years, then start scamming. You know what I'm saying? So, fuck y'all. You know what I mean? Fuck y'all.
Took me 10 minutes. Most of that is just straight through. That's why it's not rhyming in some of the parts, because it was just me telling shit. And then when I listened to it fully through, it was like, damn, okay, even though it don't rhyme, fuck it. And it worked. I was going broke trying to go into the studio, you feel me? So this shit really panned out for me. And that's really just me telling my life. So I understand when people be like, be real in your raps and this shit might go through. Like, that shit really works for real. Just be real in your raps. It's gonna work. Well, it's not gonna work for everybody, but you know. Let me tell y'all about this one time at Walmart. Walked in and played it so smooth, I grabbed the shopping cart. I'm punching bar for bar. So I'm thinking while I'm in the studio. So you feel me? So it's easier to do this shit. If I'm at home writing it, and that's some bullshit. When you speaking facts, it's easy. Like, when a nigga lying, you gonna be overthinking shit. Like, all that bullshit. Break my cousin off a couple hundred because she play her part. I scammed the same Walmart 50 times. I gotta play it smart. All I know is I gotta play it smart this time. The next time, every time.
Scam the same Walmart 50 times. I gotta play it smart. That boy, smooth criminal, huh?
Go live, but look, the going in store parts, I'm not doing that no more. But scamming people, I'm still doing that to this day. I'm not gonna do that. Listen to what I gotta say, I'm about to get honest. Play the crazy like I'm shopping here for clothes and hit electronics. It's just depending on how you play. If you going inside there looking nervous and being, if you walk inside there with a feeling that you go get caught, it's a chance you're gonna get caught. Nigga, walk in there like a regular person, do your job, and get the fuck out. grabbed some Xboxes and TVs, I think about 7. I told them that these are all gifts so they won't even question. As I got up to the counter, they started asking questions. Like, am I getting these for kids or some family members? I told them because I ain't getting none for Christmas in December. She responded back like, okay, sir, I understand. Had an Xbox in my left and TV in my other hand. That should be so funny if you watch Strike Story video. I had the cameraman just record me doing it. After all them times of me actually doing it, I just said, fuck it. Called the cameraman and went in there and actually did it. Told her I think I learned from my cast and called my Jeff friend. Boy. I let 2 minutes pass by to reach inside my pocket. Now this one shit about to get real and nobody can stop it. Pulled out the debit card that I just embossed. Was hoping that the clerk ain't look at me weird and have to call the boss. A fresh piece right. That you just punched up, you really can't just go to the store after. You gotta let it dry, like, you feel me? So it can look like a brand new piece. And you gotta actually scratch it up, damage it yourself. Like, this is what I be doing. I be, after I print my fake IDs and shit, I get some aluminum foam, wrap them up in that, put it on the floor and scrape it all the ground so it look like an old ass ID. You know what I mean?
Hey, full flesh with brand new ass
laminated ID. That shit gonna look stupid. She asked me what I like to do. I said playing golf. I stuttered when she asked that question. I had to play it off. She said my total was $2,500 plus taxes. Thinking to myself, soon as we done, I'm getting X maxes. She bagged everything up and put them in the cart. My shit approved. I no longer got a racing heart. If you walking out being a regular person, if you have a regular outfit on, if you're not wearing no designer looking flashy, no jewelry, you're cool, man. All you gotta do is walk out of there with your shit. I was
That's another reason why he didn't cut his hair.
Even though it went through, I still gotta play it smart, because I was here for gift cards from the very start. First time I actually went to a store, it was Dollar General. This one, the gift cards was popping, though. So around this time, you can walk into a store with a fire piece that you just punched up and buy some gift cards, some reloadable gift cards below $500 on each one. I used to say I'm getting teddy bear for my little sister because she just graduated, and I want to get her some gift cards, so it's like a gift. As soon as you walk out, you gotta keep driving around the city, though, to stack up the gift cards. You don't want to just go cash in a little take a thousand. So you gotta keep driving around the city. So you stack up like 20 can gift cards or like 10 can gift cards so you feel comfortable. Drive back to the city, go downtown to Uber, check cash in all your shit. Now I'm about to go to aisle 7 with my cousin. She let me slide at any time and I'm loving it. She let me push through 5,000, then I double back. So you can add it up yourself how much I made in here. Got all the items that I needed, then I disappeared. Rental was filled up with Xboxes and TVs. Was hot as hell on our way to AT&T. Plus, I had my Bluetooth MSR on the back seat. It's different types of MSRs, but my favorite one, MSR X6. For everybody who keep asking, that's where I got the X6 from, the MSR. Too hot to take the freeway, we took the back street. I'm lucky we didn't get caught on our way to the phones. Walked in smooth, we gotta go through these same steps. Before I walk in, I gotta take a breath. Walk up to the counter, can I apply for iPhone X? All my profiles got good credit, so I'll be paying less. $400 down payment, but I ain't even stressed. Giving me all free sauce on the game, by the way. For the iPhone, you can go to that shit easy too, as long as you got a head to walk in, get ahead, apply for the iPhone X's. Just go listen to my songs. I love a profile with 700 credit score, because I can grab 4 iPhones and grab some more. If I was doing it online, it'd be way quicker. Punch however much the fees get next day shipping, and catch me somewhere where my plug next day flipping. Y'all really don't know what I'm talking about, but people watching know what I'm talking about. So if I was doing it online, you can punch the fees, it'd be way quicker and it'd be a low risk instead of you walking into the store with somebody and actually doing it. So if you're doing it online, you would get more iPhones and you would get approved. It's a better chance of you getting approved than actually walking into the store. If you get next day shipping, go to your plug, you can go to any Metro PCS. Y'all probably don't got that down here, but Metro PCS, you can go sell the phones like 800 or something. Off of this nigga alone, I made 6 figures. I get a 1,000-ary Jackie and Mount Clemens. Basically, it's Apple. You know how Apple got the iPhones, Apple Jacks. So iPhones is just Detroit slang. Y'all go catch on eventually, though. I'm about to have a mixtape coming out called The Fraud Bible. I got like 7 methods in here and they all still work. Whenever you buy Fraud Bible, you gonna get The Fraud Bible, you feel me? So I'ma just email it to everybody who copies.
Go get The Fraud Bible ASAP.
When everybody who watching, if you fuck with me, you fuck with me. If you hating on me, fuck you. Real if you shit. See me out in public, I'ma murder you, nigga.
Oh, my mama, he not playing. He not playing neither. He not playing. Shout out to that boy. Much respect to that boy Teejayx6, man, because he's going to keep on grinding. He's going to keep on doing this thing. Free you, my nigga. Oh, my mama. Skim the whole system in they motherfucking face, nigga. Oh, my mama. I respect that shit, because you know what? Because you know what? They let that shit happen, boy. Straight out the gates, man. 100, 100. Man, I'm out this bitch.